Hi everyone. Well, I'm headed out to the garden today to do a little mini garden bed makeover. I've got a spot here next to one of my decks that I haven't done much with. It's got an overgrown rosemary plant, some weeds in it, and I have some cucumbers that need transplanted, so I thought I would plant them there and bring you guys along and show you what I'm doing. So let's go check it out. Well, here's this little garden bed that I'm going to plant my cucumbers in. Now, you can see that rosemary plant has just gone crazy this summer. I've got to cut it back. I'm going to take those inside, the rosemary inside, to dry it. Hopefully I'll be able to do a video on that. And the rest of the garden bed, you can see, just full of weeds. So I don't even know if the drip irrigation here is working anymore, so I'll have to test that out, possibly replace it, and we'll get some cucumbers in here for a late summer harvest. So let's go check out the plants. Now, as you know, if you've been watching my channel much this summer, I've been doing some late summer plantings of some vegetables so I can get harvests late into the fall after the summer crops have died out. So I just did a video on that last week. Now, these plants here are not part of the All America Selections winners, but I actually planted them, started them indoors. I think it was about 6 weeks ago. I believe these are a Bait Alpha cucumber. One of my favorite varieties, very tender skinned, and I think one of them is a martini, but of course, unfortunately, no tags, so we're gonna just have to guess, which is fine. And here, I've never really showed you guys this, but this is a moringa tree I started from seed. Viewer gave me the seed, so I'm really excited to hopefully bring you some more videos on that. And I just transplanted these cucumbers in this Smart Pots 20-gallon container yesterday. They are already looking fabulous. And here along the wall, I've got my Red Racer plants, which you saw on last week's video about the All-America Selections. This is a All-America Selections winner, and the tomatoes are getting bigger by the day, so I cannot wait to harvest them. And right here, these beans are looking fabulous. This 20-gallon Smart Pots. I love keeping these plants here on this wall. They're growing absolutely beautifully, getting some shade in the afternoons. But let's get back to the cucumbers. I think I'm gonna probably plant maybe two of these in that spot. And look at these cool little Smart Pots. I think they're a 1 gallon, they're called a transplanter. Aren't these cool? Look, you can fold it back and just transplant it very easily right into the soil. Well, the first order of the day is to cut back this rosemary. Now, I've had this rosemary in here three, I don't know, maybe 4 years. The funny thing is, the first couple years, it really didn't grow at all. I'm not too sure why, but then it just took off. And I mean, look at it now. It's overflowing this little garden bed here, getting in the way, getting in the walkway here. So I'm gonna take it out, make some room for my cucumbers. Whoop, my pruners are getting stuck. And this rosemary smells so good. I wish you guys could smell it. It makes this whole area smell absolutely fabulous. Oh, it's wonderful. Oh, and I'm gonna take this inside, by the way, wash it up, let it air dry, and then I'm gonna actually dry the leaves here, and I'll have a bunch of jars of dried rosemary. I can give it away to friends. So you can see my rosemary looks a whole lot neater, a whole lot tidier, is not spilling over into the walkways now. And look at all this rosemary I have to dry up. This is gonna be a little bit of a project. So hopefully I'll be able to shoot a video on that. But there's a lot of weeds in here. I'm gonna pull these out, pull out the drip irrigation hose, and we'll see what the soil is looking like. The weeds in here really aren't too bad. I did pull out a bunch of stuff out of here maybe a month or so ago just to clear it out. So not too bad on the weeds, but this drip irrigation hose I'm gonna go ahead and pull out. This is the smaller 1/4-inch soaker hose, which I'm not real fond of using in the garden beds. To me, it just doesn't get enough water coming out to really soak it down. So I'm gonna pull this out and then replace it with a hose that has like the little drip emitters. They're about 6 inches apart. So we'll get that out of here. The soil doesn't look too bad, but it definitely is gonna need some compost added to it. I've got my rosemary trimmed. I pulled out the weeds and the rocks. Now I just gotta loosen up the soil with one of my favorite garden tools, the pitchfork. And luckily it's a pretty small garden bed. Oops, there's another rock. So I should be able to do this in no time. So just loosen this up and then we will get some compost going here. Well, I actually decided to water this soil down before I add the compost because it is so, so dry. Probably hasn't been watered for a couple of months. So I'm just gonna wet it down here. And I really like to plant the plants in the soil that's already moist so that, you know, it just helps them retain water and just kind of grow really well right off the bat. So I'm just gonna mix that in, add in water till it looks nice and moist. I'm not gonna let it get too waterlogged, but just so it has some moisture in it. It's getting there. Okay, this is looking pretty good. What I like to look for is squeeze it together. Yep, that's good. It holds together like a little ball. And I'll still be adding compost to this, so that'll break it up even more. So let's go get some compost. The compost pile, I really haven't shown you guys this for a while, so I thought it might be a good opportunity. It's over here on the side of my house. You might have watched the compost videos. But basically, I have three different piles. I've got this pile here, which is my freestanding bin. Over here, I've got a finished little bin. There's some finished compost at the very bottom. And then this here is my compost sack that I am making a hot pile in. So this I started a couple of weeks ago, and it's been in progress. Turned it a couple of times already. This is nowhere near finished, but it's looking good. Wow, it looks nice and black, actually. I don't know, it doesn't feel too hot, so I probably need to mix it around a little bit, maybe add some more coffee grounds, get it heating up. But man, it's starting to break down, though. Look at this. Wow. So let's dig in here and see if there's any black gold at the bottom. It looks like it's mostly just shredded leaves. So I think what I'm going to do is take a bucketful of these down, and we'll add a little bit of bagged garden soil to the garden bed and use this for mulch. These cucumbers do like a lot of organic matter, so this will actually be perfect to use for mulch. Can't wait for my other compost sack to be ready, hopefully in time for fall veggies. Well, I'm just going to add a couple inches of organic garden soil I had left over from another project. Don't really need a lot. If you have compost, by all means use compost. Hopefully mine will be finished soon. And I just like to mix it in here. Just enough to give it some extra nutrients. Wow, it looks nice and black. Can't wait to have those fresh cucumbers again. And water it down again. It's always fun to see a garden bed transformed. And believe me, I've been wanting to get something in here all summer long, so it's been bugging me for a while. So I'm just gonna keep mixing that in a little bit. Nice. Okay, at this point, I'm gonna add some Vermistura worm castings. I love this stuff. I'm telling you, my garden has been the best ever this year. And I really feel like it's due to Vermistura worm castings and the worm tea. So I usually add a few cups in, or at least some in. This will be a few cups every time I plant something. The great thing about the worm castings, you only have to do it once a season. So I'll just take a few scoops. Sprinkle it into the soil. Maybe one more. That's it. And I get all the beneficial bacteria and microbes, and I just love the thought that those beneficial bacteria and microbes are going to work for me, helping my soil be healthy, which helps my plants be healthy. Okay, this is looking good. I think we are ready to plant. Well, before we add the plants, I completely forgot we've got to add drip irrigation here first. I really do like to add the drip irrigation before I add the plants. Just makes it a whole lot easier if you don't have to disturb the plants by installing it. And I keep all my drip irrigation supplies in this little bucket. It's just that way I can find everything because I use them so often. So I'm going to get out here's my quarter inch tubing that has the emitters. I think they're about 6 inches apart. So I'm just going to lay down a little zigzag here in this garden bed. But first I have to find where they connect to. Hopefully I didn't get buried under here, under the deck. Hopefully there is a hose somewhere. You know, we just redid this whole area back here and added mulch. Yep, I bet you we strung it across so to connect to the main supply line. So it looks like I'm gonna have to do that. So it could be a little bit of a project. Here's the garden bed I'm redoing, and I'm gonna string a small supply line that does not have drip emitters to this garden bed right here, tie it into this, it'll feed under my deck over to the other garden bed. Kind of a pain, but you know, it's worth it to get water over there, because why bother planting anything if I can't get water to it, since we get like no rain here in the summertime. So here's the supply line I'm talking about. It's a 1/4-inch poly tubing, so you can see that. I'm gonna connect it to my supply line with a little elbow joint here. So this is pretty easy to do if you've never done it. Drip irrigation is definitely the way to go. I am just going to poke a hole in my supply line here. This is my main drip irrigation line. And these sometimes can be a little bit tricky to get in, these little connectors. So what I like to do is grab my lighter. Don't tell me out of fluid. I heat this up just a little bit. Just a little bit, you don't want to melt it too much. And then this will just pop right in. Little trick. I think actually a viewer told me about it. Pop it right in. You hear that snap? That means it's in. And then I'm going to take my supply line, do the same thing to that. There we go. Heat it up just a little bit, enough to soften it. Just put it right in there. Okay. You guys can see that. Kind of wiggle it on until it's nice and tight. Okay, that's pretty good. And then we are going to feed this over to the garden bed. So I'm going to hide this as much as I can along the deck here. And I am using these landscape staples. So I brought my supply line against this deck here. And now I'm going to cut it and put in the line with the drip emitters, so I can string that and have water supply in through my garden bed here. So I'm gonna follow the same process, but this time I have a straight connector here. This is a barbed connector. This drip irrigation line, that's one reason why I love drip irrigation, is because it's so handy just to add on to your system. It can be expanded in just a matter of minutes. So heat that one up. That barb in there really, really tight. You don't want it leaking. Gonna hook that to my supply line. And this rosemary, because that other drip irrigation line was not working, the little soaker hose, has not been watered all summer. And we've gotten no rain, so it's obviously very drought tolerant. Connect the two lines. And we are good to go. Got water to the bed. What I'm gonna do now, this is just really easy. I'm just gonna wind the little poly tubing that has the emitters throughout the garden bed. So this garden bed has a nice good supply of water to it. Just gonna kind of wind it around, use my drip irrigation staples to hold it in place. And I'm going to be planting some stuff all throughout this garden bed. I've got the cucumbers coming in right now, but I'm also going to be adding some flowers along the front edge. I'm going to either plant the red profusion zinnias that are the All America Selection winners, or I've got some other flowers coming in a couple of weeks that are called Sun Patience. I may put those in around the edge here because those are beautiful flowers, really bright colors. Also an AAS winner, the particular variety that I'm going to be putting in. And I think they're going to grow great in shade or sun. So it's a really, really beautiful flower. I actually saw them when I went to the P. Allen Smith event in Arkansas. And I absolutely loved them. So they're sending me some next week. And I want to get some of those planted along the edge as well. So I'm going to measure this hose all the way to the end because I'll be putting some flowers down in here on this end as well. And then I am just snipping the end here. And I put in one of these goof plugs to plug the end. Now it goes this way. I love this little trick. There we go. Now, I always like to test out to see if my drip irrigation is working before I put the plants in. A little bit of water takes a little time to build up. But over here, definitely got some water there. I think we're good to go on the water. Now, finally, let's get the plants in. Well, first, I always like to set my plants out in my garden beds so I can kind of figure out where they're going to go. And I'm actually going to stake these up with a tomato cage. So I'm going to stick it right there. I always like to put it, of course, by a drip emitter so it gets plenty of water. Now, cucumbers I like to plant pretty close together, maybe, I don't know, 6 inches or so apart. And I've got this tomato cage here. So I kind of want to just get an eyeball of if these plants will both work with this tomato cage. Looks like it will. I'll probably just put the cage right here, and then the plants can kind of climb up it. So let's dig a hole here. And these transplanters are going to be really easy to plant in. I'm just going to dig a hole about the depth of the transplanter. I'll put that there so you can kind of see it. Soil is nice and loose after we loosened it up. Looks nice and black. These are going to be nice right here. Okay, it's a good, pretty good depth. Now, it's going to need a little bit more organic amendment. I'm going to throw in some Trifecta Plus. I have it here in a coffee can. Probably a couple tablespoons or so. Maybe, yeah, 2 or 3 tablespoons would be good. And then I'll start with this plant. Pull this out of the transplanter. These are so easy to get out of here. I really like these. Just fold back the fabric. Pop them right out. You don't have to worry about trying to dump the plant out upside down or pull it out by the stem and breaking the stem. It's really, really easy. Just comes right off here. There we go. Set it right down in the hole. Make sure I got some, yep, I got some good drip irrigation right next to it. Kind of push it down in there. There we go. It always feels good to get some plants in the ground. Wow. Okay, I'm gonna put the other one in and then we'll come back and put the tomato cage in and we're almost done. The plants are in, they're looking good. I'm really excited about my little garden bed makeover here. I'm watering it now with some of the Vermistera worm tea. I like to do that every time I plant anything. Gets them off to a great start. So give them a nice little drink. And don't want to forget the mulch here. I'll spread a couple inches over the top. Keep them nice and damp, keep the soil nice and damp. Can't wait to get the flowers in. That's going to really make it pretty. And good to go with our tomato cage now. And what I'll do is just tie the cucumbers to the tomato cage as they grow, kind of weave them in and out of the tomato cage. That way they have some support. They're not flopping all over the place. The plants will stay a lot healthier that way. They'll look a lot prettier that way. And we are done. This one does not want to go in. Probably hit a patch of, there we go, a patch of compacted soil there. But we are done. Thank you guys so much for joining me here on the little mini garden bed makeover. It was a lot of fun to spend a morning with you in the garden. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you comment down below. Let me know how things are going in your garden. If you're planting anything, how things are growing in your late summer garden. And if you're going to be growing that late summer garden with me of the AAS winners, make sure you let me know that as well. All right, guys, I got to sign off. I actually have someone at the door. So anyway, we'll see you later. Bye-bye.